In this tutorial, we're going to cover super slow motion using a native effect in Final Cut called Optical Flow. Optical Flow is perfect for sports-related clips or if you shoot with an action cam. You can slow down your footage to dramatically low speeds while keeping things smooth and high quality. Let's jump into Final Cut and see what we can create. So optical flow is a lot different than traditional time remapping methods. To demonstrate the difference, I'm going to slow down this shot to 10% without optical flow. You can find all the retiming options here. Under slow, we'll select 10%. This shot is 60 frames per second. When slowed down to 10%, it's essentially stretching out those frames and we're left with a 6 frames per second video. This is what it looks like. It's super choppy. Optical flow works by filling in those gaps. It's creating new frames in between the originals, so we're not left with choppy playback. Let's apply it to the same clip. Under the retiming options, we can find optical flow under video quality. Here's the result. The difference in fluidity is incredible. Let's try another shot. I have this beach scene. What we'll do is splice a few frames right around here. Let's slow it down to 25% and apply optical flow. Now, if we want to increase or decrease the percentage, we can actually grab this tab at the end and simply drag. Final Cut Pro offers a magnetic timeline, so we don't have to worry about overriding the clip to the right. Everything just adapts accordingly. Let's take a look at our shot. Super awesome. So that is the optical flow feature in Final Cut Pro. It's super fun to play around with, and you can make nearly any shot look super epic. I hope you enjoy, and thanks for checking out this tutorial.